thank y'all for coming this morning. We were hoping to be out in the farmer's sheds, but Mother Nature is doing us a favor with a little bit of rain this morning, so we're glad for that for our farmers across the state. I'm Hugh Weathers, your South Carolina Commissioner of Agriculture. We're here to mark a pretty significant turn for South Carolina agriculture in the passage of the Industrial Hemp Bill and what it can mean for South Carolina farmers. And we want to share a little bit of that with you today. I want to thank all of the industry and other leaders who brought this day about, from the efforts in the State House and the Governor McMaster, who will speak to it later. In that regard, in South Carolina, the legislative effort was truly a broad mix representing agriculture and interest and otherwise. At the forefront of that effort was Representative Russell Ott, who's with us today. I want to ask Russell to come to the podium and share some of his thoughts for future farming with industrial hemp. Thank you, Russell.
Thanks, Governor. Good morning. Just want to say how great of a day it is to be in South Carolina today as we start out on a brand new adventure with farmers in the state of South Carolina being allowed legally to grow hemp. This has been a long time coming. We've been working on this for several years now, and there's been some hurdles that we've had to clear, but I'm just very excited to be able to stand here today with my good friend, Representative Mike Pitts, and I think this has been a great example of bipartisan leadership, where Democrats and Republicans can come together and see a need and figure out a way to accomplish it, and that's exactly what we did. And as you can see by so many people in this room, it was not just us. This was a team effort from business and leaders and folks all across the state of South Carolina that decided this is something that they wanted to do. It made no sense why we had these ridiculous restrictions in place to be able to grow just a simple crop. And so we all came together and we passed this legislation to open up those barriers. And it's very exciting. I cannot tell you how many people I've heard from across the entire state since this legislation was passed that are asking how they're able to go about doing it. So we're starting out small, but the growth potential for this particular crop, this commodity, is huge. And I look forward to being able to look back one day and be very proud to have played a very small part in allowing this to come. Thank you very much.
Representative Mike Pitts, District 14, co-author with my good friend and bipartisan co-author of this bill. You know, this bill this issue is what can be collateral damage when government gets involved in liberties. And that's exactly what happened here in the war on drugs. And basically declared in 1970 by then President Richard Nixon, caught hemp up because it is a cousin to marijuana as a cannabis plant. It's never been proven to be detrimental in any way to health or anything else. So after that point, any industrial use of hemp had to be done by bringing it in from overseas. That makes no sense. This bill is the epitome of something rarely seen in government at any level, and that's the exercise of common sense to allow our farmers to grow, produce, manufacture, and then sell within our own country a product that never should have been deemed illegal to begin with. The exercise of common sense, and I thank you, Governor McMaster, for being ready to sign this bill today and further exercise common sense.
Thank you, Representative Ott and Pitts. Let me make a few comments and then introduce the governor. As was said, a great deal of interest in this bill, from the number of phone calls we've received in the Department of Agriculture from farmers of all sizes, history, all across the state, the interest is there in the farming community. Farmers, while we've suffered some weather challenges over the last few years, now suffering some economic challenges with markets the way they are. So the advent of hemp as a new member of our crop mix in South Carolina is welcome news. As we go through this learning process of 20 farmers this year, and then next year, the Department of Agriculture and others will take the responsibility of developing a market and processing facilities for hemp in South Carolina. Currently, we don't have any here. We have them in neighboring states, but one of the successes means that we do value added of our crops here in the state, and hemp would be one of those. We want to make the process a non-bureaucratic way for farmers to apply, and after the governor finishes his remarks, we'll come back with questions and answers and answer some of those specifics. So again, we're very excited to be adding industrial hemp to the crop mix of South Carolina, and as we move forward, it'll be a great collaboration with the Department of Agriculture and Clemson and South Carolina State as we go into this research phase of the industrial hemp, which is a requirement of the Farm Bill, federal law passed in 2014. As was said, in South Carolina, it just doesn't happen without support of both the legislature and the executive branch. So we very much appreciate Governor McMaster's support of this bill. I think he's a farmer at heart, because as he travels the state, he always reports to me on the condition of the corn crop or the cotton crop that he travels about. So today, I don't know if he's going to give you a farm report, but we do welcome Governor Henry McMaster to make comments on the industrial hemp. Thank you, Governor.
Thank you. I'm happy to be here as well. And of course, it's been mentioned, you have to have teamwork. And if we collaborate, what I've seen over the years in South Carolina, when we collaborate, there's not another state that can keep up with us. And as has been mentioned there about cousins, one plant being a cousin, if we outlawed cousins in South Carolina, wouldn't be anybody left. We're all cousins, I think. But this opens a big door for South Carolina. Agriculture is our biggest business. I think it's $41 billion. It's a huge number. And we have a lot of untapped potential in agriculture as well, as you've seen when you go around the state. So this opens a door. We know it will be profitable. We know that this plant can grow almost anywhere. It takes very little water. It sounds like it's almost indestructible to bugs. It's resistant to most kind of bugs. And it can make, it forms a basis for all sorts of things, from fabrics to clothes to, somebody wearing some hemp in here right now. I know they're in the seats of a lot of cars, the fabric. So this may reopen the textile industry for us a little bit too. But it's a good step forward. It's a common, as Mr. Pitt said, it's a common sense step forward. And agriculture is very important. It's getting more and more important in our economy in South Carolina. And I want to compliment and thank all those who worked so hard to put this together. We're going up, and this is another step up that great stairway that we're going up to enormous prosperity. Thank you.
Thank you, Governor. Let me read, if you're not familiar, some of the specifics of the bill, and then after that, Governor McMaster will sign some copies of the bill. But the bill that was passed, as Representative Ott said, we're starting slow. We'll have 20 farmers permitted this year for 20 acres each. Next year, we'll move to 40, and in year three, we'll move beyond that. We will have a pretty strict scrutiny of our applications. The applications have to pass a federal and state background conducted by SLED. We'll have to know where it's being grown, including the GPS coordinates. It's only, as we said, due to the federal law, it's got to be a part of a research process. So they will need to associate with a research project. Open to South Carolina residents only. They need to have a signed contract for their crop so they know where it's going. The crop must be tested to be 0.3 THC or lower, so that it does not reach over into its cousin's territory. So as we choose these applicants, and as I said, the numbers, we don't know the numbers, but the interest is certainly great. We will look for farmers to have a good mix that first year of experienced farmers, large farmers, small farmers from all parts of the state, because we have different soils around the state. And what we're trying to do is learn our yield potentials for the crop in the first few years. So the farmers who apply need to, just like when we had the farm aid, they need to have a farm number from the U.S. Department of Agriculture. So we'll take all of these things into account to select our 20 farmers for the first year, and get the process rolling and then move to 40 the next year. So before we have the governor sign the bill, I think we'll open it up for a couple of questions.
What is that application process, sir?
Thank you. Yeah, we hope to be up we said July 1, it may end up July 8. That it'll be up on our website, which is agriculture.sc.gov, and it'll answer all the questions that an applicant would have.
Commissioner, what is the planting season for hemp, and what's the season like for hemp?
Season is in that we hope to have all this done by November with the process and get the seed in, which is a logistical issue to deal with, and then the spring is the planting season.
How fast is it to harvest?
In the fall, frankly, when it comes to growing, I better go to a better expert than me, but as the governor said, it's a relatively easy crop to grow. What we're hoping is on some of our lesser quality soils, it can follow them. Give you an example, 60 years ago, 70, the soybean came on the scene. Kind of a new crop for South Carolina farmers. It has more uses than probably any other crop that we grow, very versatile, and now it grows on more acres in South Carolina than any other crop. So will hemp follow that? Not on that scale, but the precedent is there for a new crop to come into our mix, take place on some of our soils, and give a good crop rotation.
You said you've heard from farmers. What are they saying to you? Are they excited about this?
They are. Again, I mentioned the economic pressure that are on farmers now with our market prices. So they're looking for something to add for the diversification.
And I know we've had some previous other seeds kind of come in, other potential cultivation, like for flax, for example, that kind of was a false start in some areas of the state. Do we see hemp as being more of a sustainable crop to keep growing in South Carolina into the future?
I think it will be in this learning stage. Year one and year two will help us toward that. And again, I think one of the keys to the profitability is the markets that we can develop within South Carolina, nearby to the growth areas, for value added. I will say this, we are in conversations this week with manufacturers in South Carolina who might be a good partner for some of this. Don't want to speak to specifics, but as you can imagine, it's a pretty short list, who might use it for fabric. Also, other groups have looked at this crop as an energy alternative. So can we pelletize it and put it on the grid to do cogeneration with coal, those types of many applications that are out there, and now over this startup period of time to learn what they all are.
Okay, thank you.
All right, thank y'all for coming. The governor's gonna sign, and I will tell you on a personal note, I told my granddaughter this morning this press conference was not for her birthday because her birthday was 3:30 this morning. She wouldn't have understood if I told her. Governor.
All right.
We're gonna look at you first.
We're gonna look right here first. And then everyone just look down at the bill as he signs.